गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स इन शिवाजी ग्रुप ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूशन ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। आई एम साइलेंस सैनी, योर फिजिक्स इंग्लिश मीडियम टीचर। स्टूडेंट्स, इन आवर टूडेज लेक्चर वी विल टॉक अबाउट डिस्प्लेसमेंट एंड टाइम ग्राफ। ओके, सो बिफोर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द टॉपिक वी वुड लर्न समथिंग इम्पॉर्टेंट टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस डिस्प्लेसमेंट एंड टाइम ग्राफ। एंड द टॉपिक वी आर डिस्कसिंग हेयर इज लीनियर मोशन बिफोर डिस्कसिंग द डिस्प्लेसमेंट एंड टाइम ग्राफ। सो स्टूडेंट, व्हाट इज लीनियर मोशन? फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज हेयर, व्हाट इज लीनियर मोशन? लीनियर मोशन इज लाइक व्हेन एन ऑब्जेक्ट मूव्स इन अ स्ट्रेट पाथ विदाउट चेंजिंग इट्स डायरेक्शन ऑफ मोशन, देन दिस टाइप ऑफ मोशन इज कॉल्ड लीनियर मोशन। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, सपोज यू आर हेयर at a point say A and you are moving towards east in a straight path, and you moved and reached at a point B which is situated some distance, let's say 5 meters from the initial point where you have started your motion, that is A. So this type of motion is called linear motion. And students, here you can travel this distance by two ways. There are two types of motion here. First one is you can move with constant velocity, you can move with constant acceleration. So what it means, when I am saying that you are moving with constant velocity, it means velocity is not changing with respect to time. It means object is not accelerating, its acceleration is zero. Okay, when object velocity is continuously changing and the change in the velocity is constant with respect to time, as we discussed in the acceleration video lecture, that the acceleration is constant. And in there are these two types of motion related to linear motion. Now we are going to discuss here what is distance and displacement in such a case. What is the distance and displacement in such a case? Suppose here you are, you were here and you moved 5 meters towards east and you reached at point B. So student, here the distance traveled, a distance moved by you is simply 5 meters. As I told you in the first video lecture, that distance is what? Distance is the length of the path traveled by the object, is called distance. So here the path length is 5 meters. So the distance traveled would be 5 meters. So it is the distance. Now what about displacement, students? What is displacement here? Displacement would also be equal to 5 meters. Displacement भी 5 meters होगा. क्यों होगा? क्योंकि आपको पता है displacement क्या होता है. It is the minimum distance between the initial and final point. So what is initial point? A. What is the final point? B. What is the minimum distance? Just join the both the points and the length of the line segment would provide you the displacement, as I told you in the previous lecture. So here displacement would also be equal to 5 meters. It means the magnitude of displacement is same with the distance traveled. So it is for only linear motion here. So students, यहाँ पर एक चीज और है, displacement आपको पता है it is a vector quantity, so I can also यहाँ पर हम लोग also क्या कर सकते हैं, यहाँ पर direction भी कर सकते हैं, लिख सकते हैं. तो direction यहाँ पे क्या होगी, 5 meters किस direction में था? East में. तो हम लोग यहाँ लिख सकते हैं towards east. So here the difference is creating by the direction, not the magnitude of the displacement. Okay, so here 5 meters but direction is what? Towards east. So this is the concept, but I am not getting this, I am not observing, not telling you this point especially here. I am telling something else, and what it is. So let's start. Suppose students, object is here and it is moving in a straight path A to B. Suppose distance, let's take path length 10 meters. Okay, and there is a one way, one another way. Suppose object is moving like such this type of motion, and he is also reaching at a point B. So here one object, first object is moving in a straight path, that is linear motion, and the second object, this one is moving like this. This is not the linear motion and he is also reaching at point B. ठीक है, तो यहां पर आपको मैं इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट ये समझाना चाह रहा हूं स्टूडेंट. इन द फर्स्ट केस व्हेन फॉर द ऑब्जेक्ट फर्स्ट द डिस्टेंस एंड डिस्प्लेसमेंट बोथ आर सेम इन मैग्नीट्यूड. ओके, फर्स्ट वन केस में लीनियर मोशन के केस में डिस्टेंस ट्रेवल्ड एंड डिस्प्लेसमेंट का जो मैग्नीट्यूड है बोथ आर 10 मीटर. बट जो सेकेंड केस आपका है बिकॉज इट इज नॉट द लीनियर मोशन हेयर the distance would be something else to the displacement. Displacement for the second position is what? As I told you, here the initial point is A and the final point is also B. Just join them by a line segment. So I joined them by a line segment and the length of the line segment would tell you displacement, which is 10 meter. So for the second object, displacement is 10 meter. Again, but the distance traveled by the second object would not be equal to the 10 meter because it is the length of the path traveled by the object. And as you are seeing there, this is the path which he is traversing. So the distance moved by the object would not be similar to the displacement where it is non-linear motion. So student, this is an important point which I am telling you here. So notice this point in very concentrated manner. So, and one more important point is here. Suppose students, this is a reference point. This is a reference point with respect to which we are going to find the displacement of the object. So, this is a point A. Suppose our object is moving towards this direction. Okay. Towards this direction, suppose this is east, okay, this is 5 meter, let it is 5 meter and he reached at B, okay. So, students here, object 1, I am naming it object 1, object 1 is moving towards east, he traveled 5 meter and reached at a point B. So, which type of motion is this? This is linear motion. So, what is the displacement here, student? Displacement would be equal to 5 meter. Displacement would equal to 5 meter. Now, you can also put the direction here because it is a vector quantity. So, your answer with direction would be 5 meter towards east. So, it would be your complete answer 5 meter towards east. ठीक है, अब यहां पर हम लोग एक और लेते हैं कि वी हैव अनदर ऑब्जेक्ट विच इज आल्सो एट इनिशियल पॉइंट ए एंड ही इज मूविंग टुवर्ड्स वेस्ट इन अ स्ट्रेट लाइन एंड ही मूव्ड डिस्टेंस 5 मीटर एंड रीच्ड एट अ पॉइंट सी. ओके, सो द ऑब्जेक्ट सेकेंड ऑब्जेक्ट इज मूविंग टुवर्ड्स द वेस्ट एंड ही मूव्ड 5 मीटर इन अ लीनियर मोशन एंड रीच्ड एट अ पॉइंट सी. So, what is the displacement of the second object, student? Displacement of the second object would also be equal to 5 meter. And the direction, if we talk about the direction, then the 5 meter towards west. So, what is the point here? The point is here, this is the 5 meter towards east, this is the 5 meter towards west. There is only the difference which is here by the direction. Direction is creating the difference only. You are seeing that the magnitude of the displacement is same in both the cases. And there is another way which I could represent these two answers. So what it is, that is the important point which I am going to tell you. The important point here, suppose I am writing this answer like this. Displacement, simply we are writing it as 5 meter. I am writing it as 5 meter. And for this, I am writing it as minus 5 meter. So, what is the important point, students, here? Important point is here that if this displacement for the same path, for the same motion, same question, if this is 5 plus 5 meter and this is minus 5 meter, it means if the object this is moving towards east, then this object is moving opposite to the direction which the first one is moved. This is the important point. It means अगर ये object आपका जिस भी direction में इसने move किया होगा, ये जो आपका दूसरा object है, इसका जो motion होगा, minus sign यहाँ पे आपको सिर्फ indicate कर रहा है कि minus sign का मतलब यहाँ पे आपका है कि जो direction of motion है, it is just opposite to the direction of motion which the first object moved. Okay? तो यहाँ पर ये आपको important point समझना है. Suppose इसने move किया किधर north की तरफ, तो it means this object is moving towards south 5 meter. Okay? So this is the important point student here. But these two points which I have told you is very important for the graphical point of view to understand the displacement and time graph very clearly. So I am repeating this what I told you. First one is linear motion. As I told you, what is linear motion, student? When an object moves in a straight path, in a straight line without changing its direction of motion, it is called linear motion. And I told you example, suppose an object is a point, any point A, and he is moving towards right, yeah, towards east 5 meter, and finally he reached at a point B. So what is the distance? Distance is simply 5 meter because it is the length of the path, and the length of the path you are clearly seeing here is 5 meter. And what is the displacement of the object? Displacement is, as I told you, for finding the displacement you have to just join the initial and final point by a line segment, and you have to find the length of that line segment. That would give you the magnitude of the displacement for your numerical problem. So here the student, displacement is again 5 meter, but what is the difference here? Difference is by the direction, because this is the vector quantity, then I am writing the direction here so that these two answers could be differentiate. So here direction is towards east, okay, but magnitude wise both are the same. Now our important point is here is this. This was our important point. Suppose an object is moving a linear motion and it moves 10 meter and finally reached at a point B. So it is moving in a straight line without changing its direction of motion. It means in case of linear motion, for the first object, what is the distance? Distance is 10 meter. What is the displacement? Displacement is again 10 meter for the object number 1, which is moving linearly. Now for the second case, for the second object which is not moving linearly because its direction is changing at every point here, you are seeing that it is moving like this, in this direction, now he changes direction this way, then finally he is changing its direction in whole the journey. It means it is not the linear motion. And in case of linear motion for the object number second, there you are seeing here that the distance is like distance traveled, distance is the path, length of the path traveled, which is different from the displacement, because the for the object number second, displacement is also 10 meter. So this is the important point here, that in case of linear motion, distance and displacement is mostly same. But it is not true for the case non-linear motion. Now the second point is which I told you here is was in case of linear motion, suppose an object is moving 5 meter towards east and another object is starting the traveling the motion, yeah, starting the motion from the same point, and it is moving towards west and same length of the path 5 meter, then how we could represent these two answers? So there is 5 meter towards east because I am writing the direction here, so we have write it in full form. But if we are just writing 5 meter and we are taking it as positive, then what is second answer would be? It would be negative with respect to first one, because it, what this negative sign indicating here, this negative sign is indicating you have to note this point here clearly. There's this negative sign is indicating just that the direction of motion of the second object is just opposite to the direction of the motion of the first object. So these are the two points which is very important to understand the displacement and time graph. So I think you have cleared idea about these two points. Now we will discuss the displacement and time graph, which would be very easy for you now. Thank you. So, I am
taking an example and
making a graph simply. And student, I told you how to make the graph, and I think you have did it in your homework. So, here I am making it a graph to discuss I am taking it as 5 difference, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35 and 40, and this one is 45. This is displacement time graph. This is displacement and it is in meter, so I am writing small m here, and this is time axis. In x axis I am making it as time axis, time, and it is in second. So student, you have to make the graph like this, and this is our origin points. So here coordinates is 0, 0. As I told you already, this one is first mark, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, 8, 9 and 10. Okay. Finally, I am taking it as 5 second duration, 5, 10, 15, 20 and this is 25, 30, 35, 40, 45 and finally 50. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50. Okay, students. And making a graph here. So, what it is? It is like this. I am making it here. This is point A, point B, this is point C, this is point D, this is point E. So, we are going to discuss, student, this graph. Okay? Here. So, at t equal to 0, as I told you, what is t equal to 0 point, time equal to 0, it means you have just started your observing the motion of the object. So when you observe the object, when you observe the object, its displacement at point of observation is zero. As you are seeing in the graph here, at t equal to 0, displacement is also 0 here because the graph is starting from the origin. So at t equal to 0, displacement is 0. What it means? It means when you observe the object, it is at the reference point. So its displacement from the reference point is 0. Okay. Now, after 5 or 10 seconds, after 5 or 10 seconds, you see that its displacement is changing. Because you are seeing here at t equal to 10, it is displaced 15 meter. You are seeing in the graph at t equal to 10 second, the displacement is 15 meter. It means object is displaced from its reference point, from its reference point by the distance 15 meter. Okay. Now, if we talk about, if we consider, we assume that this graph is for linear motion. This graph is for linear motion. I am taking here that this graph is for linear motion because in your syllabus linear motion is there, because so that's why I am taking it as for linear motion. So for linear motion, you are seeing here that the displacement is 15 meter after 10 second. Now here you are seeing that this is a straight line. This is a straight line. What it means, students, here, as I told you in a linear motion case, the distance and displacement are magnitude wise both same. Okay, यहाँ पर आप देख रहे हैं, सपोज मान लीजिए ये इसका स्टार्टिंग में जीरो था, देन ये क्या हो गया 5. सपोज यहाँ पर इस तरीके की सिचुएशन क्रिएट नहीं होगी, जैसे यहाँ पर मान लीजिए आप स्टार्टिंग में ये ऑब्जेक्ट ए पॉइंट पे था और दिस इज द रेफरेंस पॉइंट फॉर द ऑब्जेक्ट एंड so the displacement initially is 0 and finally it reached at a point B. So it can reach by straight line, it can reach non-linearly, but as I clearly mentioned here that we are talking about linear motion, it means it is moving like this only. And finally what distance he moved, what displacement is there? 15 meter. Okay, so 15 meter is here. Now it means this distance is also 15 meter. Okay, from here its distance is also 15 meter. Now for the point A to B, what you said about this part of the graph A to B, here for A to B you are seeing that for 10 second, because it is 10 second, it is 25, so it is 10, this 25, so this is 15 second time interval, 15 second time interval, and it is at same displacement. Here displacement is not changing. So what it means, students, in case of linear motion, as you already we discussed, suppose object is here and it moved towards any direction in a straight path, and finally he traveled 15 meter and reached at a point B. Now if the displacement is not changing, so What are the possibilities here for the linear motion? There is only one possibility. That one is object is at the same point. It means object is at rest because it cannot move like this and comes again at that point. Because if it is moving like that and after 15 seconds reached at the same point, then this is not the linear motion as you are seeing here, and you have already known what is the linear motion. So this case is not possible, that after moving 15 second here and there and again after 15 second he reached at the same point. It means here displacement is zero. It is not the case here. And as you are seeing here that during the 10 to 15 second continuously graph is maintaining that displacement 15 seconds. So this case, this one, if you are, this point is, this confusion is in your mind, it would be not possible for here. Okay, so it would be not possible. It means A to B part is showing that the object is at rest. Okay, now what about B to C? What about B to C? अब आप B to C को देखिए क्या हो रहा है यहाँ पर. यहाँ पर आप देख रहे हैं B to C में object जब C पर पहुँच गया. When object is at C, here the displacement is zero. So what it means, student? It means object is here. Object was here. आफ्टर 25 सेकेंड ऑब्जेक्ट वॉज हेयर, ठीक है। इसके बाद आफ्टर फर्दर 10 सेकेंड 25 to 35 इस डिस्प्लेसमेंट बिकम जीरो। सो इन केस ऑफ लीनियर मोशन वेदर ऑब्जेक्ट इज ट्रेवलिंग फर्दर इन अ डायरेक्शन या इट इज ट्रेवलिंग बैक, इन बोथ टू केसेस इन विच केस द डिस्प्लेसमेंट वुड बी जीरो। आई थिंक इट वुड बी जीरो इन दिस केस व्हेन इट मूव्स टूवर्ड्स ए, देन इट डिस्प्लेसमेंट वुड बिकम्स जीरो। सो दिस इज द केस विच द ग्राफ इज शोइंग हियर बी टू सी, इट मीन्स ऑब्जेक्ट इज मूविंग टूवर्ड्स इट्स इनिशियल पॉइंट। ओके, नाउ वॉट अबाउट सी टू डी, हियर यू आर सींग द डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज निगेटिव एज आई टोल्ड यू। सो इट मीन्स ऑब्जेक्ट आफ्टर रीचिंग एट पॉइंट ए इट इज मूविंग इन द अपोजिट डायरेक्शन, इट इज मूविंग इन द अपोजिट डायरेक्शन। एंड फाइनली इफ आई मार्क इट 5, 10, 15 -15, सो ही मूव्ड 15 मीटर टूवर्ड्स इनिशियल पॉइंट टूवर्ड्स अपोजिट डायरेक्शन फ्रॉम द डायरेक्शन वेयर ही मूव्ड फर्स्ट। सो नाउ ही हैज मूव्ड इन द अपोजिट डायरेक्शन फ्रॉम द डायरेक्शन ट्रेवल्ड ए मूव्ड बिफोर फर्स्ट। ओके, नाउ व्हाट अबाउट डी टू ई, डी टू इज सेम बिकॉज हियर द यू आर सीइंग दैट द डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज हियर जीरो, सो इट मीन्स डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज नॉट चेंजिंग हियर, सो इट मीन्स ऑब्जेक्ट इज at rest after traveling 15 meter in the direction opposite to the direction which he already traveled. So this is all about this graph discussion. I think you have cleared idea about, and in the next lecture we will tell you that how we find the velocity, how we find the other things from this graph. So study it from your point of view, and if you have any confusion then ask me. Thank you, students.